Today we will study about different structural levels of proteins. Individual protein molecules can be described by up to 4 levels of structures, that is primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. Okay? So first we will see primary structure of protein, that is also designated as 1-degree. It describes the linear sequence of amino acid residues in a protein and it includes all the covalent bonds between amino acids. Okay, so the amino acids which are present from M terminus of a polypeptide chain to C terminus in the sequence and linked with the peptide bond represent the primary structure of proteins. Okay, now the secondary structure of protein, that is designated as second degree, it is defined as the local conformation of its backbone. That means now linear structure can be folded back on itself and can form secondary structures, and it talks about the forces that are keeping a molecule in coil formation form to stabilize structure. So in this structure the stabilizing force is hydrogen bonds. So many two types of secondary structures are there. First one is the alpha helical structure. The alpha helical structure was proposed in 1950 by Pauling and Torre. And in theory, an alpha helical helix can be either right-handed or left-handed. Okay, so the polypeptide backbone is tightly bound around the long axis of the molecule. Suppose this is the long axis and the linear polypeptide chain is bound around upon this axis in either right-handed manner or a left-handed manner, and the R groups of the amino acids protrude outward from the helical backbone, that means towards outside. Okay, so here I just tried to explain the structure of alpha helix. Okay, you can see here this is the axis. Okay, and to this axis the polypeptide chain is wound around in right-handed manner, and suppose these are amino acids A1, A2, A3 show the sequence of amino acid. This is the N terminus and this is the C terminus. Okay, so some of the important features of this alpha helical structure is that first one I have already told you, that is alpha helix can be either right-handed or left-handed. Then second one, the pitch of the helix is 0.54 nanometer, that means pitch of the helix, that means similar position occur after 0.54 nanometer, or we can say that a complete turn is about 0.54 nanometer. Then second one is the distance between two amino acid. The distance between two amino acid is 0.15 nanometer. So complete turn, you can see here the complete turn can contain 3.6 amino acids, and in this 3.6 amino acids one carbonyl group is included, then 3 NC alpha C carbon units and one nitrogen atom is there. When we divide the complete distance of complete turn with the distance between two amino acids, we get this value, that is 3.6 amino acids. Okay, now the important next point is each carbonyl oxygen of the polypeptide backbone is hydrogen bonded to the backbone amide hydrogen of the fourth residue, that is N plus 4 residue. You can see here, suppose this is the first one amino acid, and the carbonyl oxygen of this amino acid is hydrogen bonded to N plus 4, that means fifth amino acid, just like this. Then second it will hydrogen bonded to A6, of 3 it will hydrogen bonded to A7, like this. Okay, now you can see here this hydrogen bonds are, you can see here these hydrogen bonds are parallel to the axis. Okay, they are parallel to the axis. Now each hydrogen bond closes a loop. If we see only this, the hydrogen bond present between A1 and A5, you can see here there is a closed loop structure, and this closed loop structure contains 13 atoms in which 11 backbone atoms are there and one carbonyl oxygen and one amide hydrogen is there. That's why this alpha helix is called 3.6 13 helix, that means 13 atoms in a closed hydrogen bond loop and 3.6 amino acids per term are there. Okay, then this hydrogen bonds actually stabilize the helical structure of this alpha Glycine, because of its small size, it can rotate around 360 degree to carbon-carbon atom, which destabilize the helical structure. And aspartate, glutamate, lysine and arginine are because of charges present on them. If in a long stretch of this alpha helical region, many negatively charged amino acids are there or positively charged amino acids are there, they will repel each other, which will destabilize the alpha helical structure. But if they are positively and negatively charged amino acids are present in a proper distance, then they can stabilize the structure. But they are present in a continuous one with the same charge, then they will destabilize the structure. Then two amino acids are there, proline and hydroxyproline, which break the alpha helix, because the amino group of proline is involved in ring formation, and due to this the structure of proline is very rigid. So where the helix is turned, if there proline is present, then it will break the helix, because the proline has not any flexibility, it has a very rigid structure, so it breaks the alpha helix. Okay, now the second secondary structure is beta plated sheet structure. Again, this structure was given by Pauling and Corey in 1951. They postulated that there is the existence of a different secondary structure that is known as beta plated sheet structure. As the name suggests, pleated sheet structure, that means it is very extended structure, and in this structure hydrogen bonds can be either interchain or intrachain, that means within the same polypeptide chain or between two different polypeptide chain. It is of two types, parallel beta pleated sheet structure and anti-parallel beta pleated sheet structure. In parallel beta pleated sheet structure, in the parallel beta pleated sheet structure, both the polypeptide chain run in the same direction. Both the polypeptide chain run in the same direction, from that means from same C2N terminus. You can see here, they are running from same C2N terminus. This is the one polypeptide chain, this is the C terminus of this polypeptide chain, and this is also the C terminus of this polypeptide chain. That means same group faces each other, okay? So they will repel each other, they will repel each other, and there is some distance between two parallel beta pleated sheets, and the hydrogen bonds are formed between carbonyl oxygen of one polypeptide chain and amide hydrogen of adjacent polypeptide chain, just like this. And this hydrogen bonds are formed in the form of zigzag manner. Okay. Now in the anti-parallel beta pleated sheet structure, both the chain runs in the opposite direction. This polypeptide chain runs from here and to C terminus, and this polypeptide chain runs from here and to C terminus. That means opposite groups. Amino group of one polypeptide chain and carboxylic group of adjacent polypeptide chain will face each other, that means they will interact with each other. So there is a less distance between these two polypeptide chains. Okay, so you can see here they face to each other, and hydrogen bonds are obviously formed between carbonyl oxygen of one polypeptide chain and amide hydrogen of adjacent polypeptide chain, just like this. Okay, so in this beta pleated structure for parallel conformation, the repeat period is very short. That means same position occur after 0.65 nanometer in comparison to anti-parallel beta pleated sheet structure, in which the same position occur after 0.7 nanometer. And in both the structures, parallel and anti-parallel, R groups of adjacent amino acids protrude in outward direction from the zigzag structure, and the beta pleated sheet structure has up to 15 bases long. Okay, so this is the structure of beta pleated sheet.